Let's take a look at the first question from the 2023 A-level further math test. So here we are given the polar equation, r is equal to 2 times the square root of the hyperbolic sine of theta plus the hyperbolic cosine of theta. And keep in mind, this is a polar curve. So if you graph this in the polar mode, in between of 0 and pi for theta, you will get this region here, which was actually given on the test, which is not so bad. And the goal is to find out the area of this right here. So it's actually just a pretty straightforward integration question. The area is equal to, you just have to remember the formula. I will write this down for you guys. It's 1/2, remember that it's a 1/2, and then we have the integral theta 1 to theta 2, and then r squared d theta. Some people, of course, they put a 1/2 inside, that's totally okay. And the reason that why this works is because if you look at this, and here is the origin actually. I am just going to put down the y-axis and then the x-axis. How it works is that, well, let's say we have theta 1, which is an angle like this. You are going to shoot out a ray like this. This is like theta 1, right? And then, well, each time, you're just going to have a small change in the angle theta. So I know this shape is kind of weird, but if you just rotate it just a little bit, let's say something like this. As you can see, this right here, it's a sector. So actually, let me not use theta 1. Because theta 1, I want it to be here, and theta 1, is, theta 2 is also it's going to be there. So the area of the sector right here is that, let me just remind you guys, if you have a sector, you have to look at this angle, but this angle is just a small change between the angles. So it's d theta. And then what's the r? Well, from here to here, that's the distance, that is the r, which is just like the radius of the circle, kind of. And then the area for that is precisely 1/2 r squared times the angle theta, which is d theta. You should know the formula. Anyways, let's just compute the integrals. Here, I think I have a video on this, like separately. You just replace the angles d theta, that's pretty much all. Okay, so all we have to do is area for the capital R is equal to 1/2 in the front, and then we have the integral. Theta 1 is the starting theta value, which is 0. Theta 2 is our ending value, which is pi, 0 to pi, like so. And then here, we have to square the R. The R is this thing, so be careful, including the 2 and then also the square root. Hyperbolic sine plus hyperbolic cosine, and then all that instead of the square root, all that and then square d theta, which is not so bad. Now have a look. 2 squared is 4, right? So this is 4, and then I'm just going to write it down like this. We have 1/2, and let's put a 4 on the outside. Integral going from 0 to pi, square root cancel, so we'll just have hyperbolic sine of theta plus hyperbolic cosine of theta d theta. And now put parentheses around it. And then how do you integrate that? You have two choices. The best option here is we will just change hyperbolic sine and hyperbolic cosine into its exponential form. Why? Because at the end of the day, the equation wants us to write it with e to the something. So that's the specific form that we want. Therefore, here we have the 2, and then integral 0 to pi. This right here, either you have to remember it, or the test was given. Well, this will be given on the test. I'm not so sure though, but I remember this. So here, it's like if you do this like so many times, you will just remember it. E to the negative theta over 2, and then you add this right here is e to the theta plus e to the negative theta over 2. In fact, this is the even part of e to the theta. This is the odd part of e to the theta, and this is the even part of theta. Anyways, combine them. They have the same denominator already. In fact, we can put out the 2 on the outside and then they will cancel. So it's like 2 over 2. And then here, 0 to pi. And you see that The 2 is on the outside, so this and that will cancel. Right here and right here. And then we will just have e to the theta plus e to the theta, which is 2e to the theta d theta. So they cancel to be 1, and then I'll put another 2 on the outside. Let me just try to make it clear for you guys. Right? And then integrating e to the theta in the theta world is just e to the theta. And now we are going to go from 0 to pi. So as you can see, this right here, putting the pi, 2e to the pi, and then minus putting the 0, so 2e to the 0. And finally, this right here is just 2e to the pi. And then e to the 0 is of course 1, so minus 2. So this is like a very nice first question, right? It's like get you started and all that good stuff. So that's it.